collect data. What are all the huge companies, all the massive companies, Zillow's, Apple's, Amazon's, all of them, Facebook's, what is their drug of choice? Data. Data. They're spending billions of dollars on data. Why? I don't have to sell real estate anymore. I'm to the point now where I make so much money doing other things. I don't have to sell anymore. Why do I continue to sell? Well, I love it. I love selling real estate. That's one reason why I continue to do it. It's not about the money, right? But another big reason is listen, I'm out here practicing what I'm preaching too. I'm showing you guys and leading by example. That's a big part of what I do, is leading you guys by example. So many of these coaches are out there who never even had a real estate license, or maybe sold property for 2 years and closed on 19 properties, and now they're selling courses for $500, teaching you 1980 scripts and regurgitated stuff. Listen, guys, please, let me help you guys out today, and let me change your perspective a little bit on your business, what we should be doing on a daily, weekly, monthly basis, and really build something that can withstand any market. Okay, as the market starts to shift, okay, and I don't know if you guys are experiencing this, but I know my group is experiencing this, and I started a new Discord channel, and I posted there. A lot of people are experiencing this. I posted on the Facebook group. I made a poll on my Instagram story. The consensus is that most agents are experiencing somewhat of a slowdown, like a little bit of the steam is getting let out of the market right now. And I'm not saying that this is true. I'm just telling you what agents are telling me. Listen, I think it is true to a certain extent in my local market. I get the feeling, it's more of a gut feeling. I haven't seen stats that show me, yeah, demand is down, inventory slightly up. I haven't seen any of that yet. But I'm sure we will, but whether it is or not, if we're entering into a shift, some people say that we're taking a breather and it's going to pick right back up and be red hot. We're going to be getting 30 offers for every listing again here in no time. Who knows? Nobody knows where the market's going at any time, okay? All I want to do is try to prepare you for where the market is going to go eventually. What can we do to prepare for the market, shift that's going to happen, and put ourselves in a position to really capitalize on that. Okay. So I'm going to try to accomplish a lot of things here today, guys. Right. I said, I want to help you simplify your business. I said, I want to give you a different perspective on your routines, and I want to prepare you for the next market shift that is eventually going to happen. When I look at all the lead generation sources, what I realize is that, wait a minute, all those lead generation sources all flow right back to the same exact activity. Okay, they flow back to the exact same activity. And this one activity happens to be the exact common denominator of all closings. So no matter where your leads come from, it all flows back to this one activity, that once this one activity happens, then there's a chance that from that point we can be in a business relationship, whereas we move forward with a deal either now or in the future. But all these lead generation sources flow right back to this one activity. All right, this one activity is a real conversation. Voice-to-voice real conversation is the common denominator of all lead generation sources that funnel into this one activity that leads to the closings. It's because I'm walking into every situation not caring whatsoever if they want to buy or sell today. I'm trying to listen to them about what they do want to do. I don't care about what I can't help them with. Why are you calling me? I don't want to sell my house. Good, because that's not why I'm calling. That's not why I'm calling. I'm calling you not to find out what you don't want to do. I want to know what I can do for you, what I can do for you. Right? So listen, now that we're past that, I'm not trying to sell your house today. Let me give you some value. Okay. Did you know a house around the corner just sold from you? No? Well, listen, I just dropped that golden nugget on you, and let me go further with this. Is there anything I can do for you? No? Cool. Is there an agent you would work with if you were to do something? Cool. Well, listen, I'm sure at some point in the future you're going to buy or sell. True or false? True. I would love to work with you when that day comes. Would it be all right if I just stayed in touch with you? That's all I want. Just want to stay in touch. Nothing crazy. That is okay? Cool. What's a good email for you, right? Collect data. Collect data. What are all the huge companies, all the massive companies, Zillow's, Apple's, Amazon's, all of them, Facebook's, what is their drug of choice? Data. Data. They're spending billions of dollars on data. Why? Because they're taking that data, they're building their brand, and they're using that data to sell products and to build their business. Why are we not thinking of our individual real estate businesses the same exact way? Collect data. Make friends collect data. Make friends collect data. It's real easy stuff, guys. Stop overcomplicating it. One, every relationship you put in place is worth 10 to 20 deals to you over the life of your career, regardless if they buy or sell something that day or not. Why are we going to throw away 10 to 20 deals? Why not create this great relationship, have a great conversation, regardless if they want to buy or sell or not, right? And accumulate people in our market who love us and want to do business with us. My question to you guys, why are we throwing away humans in our market who aren't motivated? They will become motivated maybe tomorrow, maybe next few minutes, maybe next week, next month, next year. I don't know. That's up to them. My job is to let them know who I am, what I do, and that I'm here to help. I'm going to collect that data, and they're never going to forget who I am, ever. It's like, okay, I just want to help people, right? But then as time went on and the market exploded and I started making all this money, It kind of went to more, I was just processing deals, and it was more of just closing deals, and it was just more just making money and competing with the other guys in the office, and it was just turned into a real competition / how many deals can we close type mentality, because I was so new in the business when the market exploded. I didn't realize that was such a short-lived market. I mean, you know, like if you get introduced into that market, you know, you just think, oh my gosh, this is how it's going to be forever. We're just going to be rich. It's just going to, and then, you know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, it was so crazy, you know, and I definitely didn't see coming what happened, or I would have definitely prepared more. And that's why I wrote the books, and that's why I do what I do, is try to prepare agents so they don't have to go through what I went through during those times. And, but no, it was all about the deals back then. It took me having to lose everything, hit rock bottom, go back to my roots of why I got in the business in the first place, to help people, read 100 books, study, think about how everything went down, to realize, wait a minute, if it would have been about people, not deals, I would have been able to continue to close deals the whole time. And not only close deals, but close a lot of deals, you know, even through those worst moments, you know what I mean? So no, it wasn't till 2008-ish when I came back in real estate, you know, in 2007, towards the end of 2007, when I really started to realize, wait a minute, you know, these people, you know, every relationship you put in place is worth 10 to 20 deals to you over the life of your career. And if I just make relationships instead of just trying to close deals, you know, when you're just so focused on deals, it's so crazy, because most people just can't wrap their head around not trying to close deals. Because I'm such a low pressure, not trying to close people kind of guy. Like, I'm going to listing appointments literally trying to talk them out of selling. And you know what I mean? Like, I'm you know, just like, please, you know, if you have another agent, that's okay. I'm just like, I just want you guys to succeed so bad, so bad. I just want to see you guys win. I just want to see you win. And when I say win, I'm talking about having a smile on your face. I'm talking about being so happy with life and enjoying your life, enjoying your career, enjoying your family, enjoying whatever it is that you do, your hobbies and everything included. I want you to enjoy it. We didn't get into real estate to be stressed out and have high anxiety and worry about deals and worry about inspections and this, that, and the other. Don't quit worrying about that stuff. I want you to be happy. Two things. I want you to be satisfied with where you are, and I want you to get better every day. I want you to work on getting better every day. Just a little bit better. Learn something new. Tweak something you're doing. Get a little better. All right? So, listen, there's been plenty of times I've hit brick walls. Okay, and listen, when I hit the brick wall, when I lost everything back in 2005, when I sold my last condo in January of 2005, before I got back into roofing mid 2005, eventually landed a job on an oil rig in 2007, the entire year of 2007. Now that was a that wasn't a brick wall because I got back in the business, but that was a heck of a road bump, right? And a lot of people would have threw in the towel right then. A lot of people would have threw in the towel right then, but I didn't. I didn't know that I was gonna get back in real estate, I'll be honest with you. On that, I'll be dead honest. I didn't know I was gonna get back into real estate. But, you know, the good Lord and, you know, fate and destiny and, you know, everything just kind of led me right back into the business. And, you know, I just think I had a lot of unfinished business, right? I wasn't going to let this business take me out like that. So everybody's different. You can't really judge the entire situation on or just give a blanket. Okay, here. And that's one thing I really disagree with on a lot of the mainstream coaches, is they give these general blanket, you know, trainings like, here's exactly what you do every time, here's what everyone should do. That's not the case. Everybody's different and has a different situations to deal with. So, you know, but just know that part of the process of taking it to the next level, especially if you're a single agent, right, is to find that level of delegation that you need to cross. And a part of that, I'll tell you this before I move on, part of that is being okay with whoever you delegate some of the tasks to. You have to be okay with those tasks not being perfect. You have to be okay with there being some mistakes. You have to be okay with them screwing up. If my assistant costs me $1,000 or $2,000 on a mistake she made, I'm fine with it. I talk to her, I'm like, what happened? She's like this. I'm like, listen, good job, because she made an executive decision without me. She makes so many executive decisions without me that it makes my life so easy. I can afford to pay for that $1,000 mistake because of all the time that she allowed me to have and gave back to me, that I invested back into my businesses, that made me, I can't even count the number. It's not 1,000, it's more like millions. More people in your local market who know who you are, that you guys have heard all this before, it's nothing new, right? I think the problem is people are trying to get around the actual sweat equity that you have to put into actually talking voice to voice to as many people as possible to create those great first impressions. I think too many of us are trying to sidestep that sweat equity you have to put into your business of the actual conversations that have to take place to create that great first impression / lifelong relationship, right? And then we need a machine in place to build our brand with that person so they never lose that feeling of that great first impression. So during the big crash, when I came back into the market, one thing I realized that I did wrong the first time, why I lost everything, was, yes, I made some bad investments, but why couldn't I continue to sell real estate? It was because of this. In the beginning, the first half of my career, I was totally focused. Yeah, I got in the business to help people, but as I got in the business and the market exploded, I started to waver from that and go more towards just get the deal done. And it would turn into more of a cold get the deal done. I wasn't really getting to know my clients. I wasn't trying to create relationships. I could literally make 5 phone calls to property owners, see who wanted to make $100,000, $200,000 on their property. At 1 out of 5 would do it. We would list it, selling it one day. You know, close it by mail. I would never even talk to the buyer sellers again and go do it again over and over and over again. You didn't have to create relationships. I was kind of thrown into that environment, right? So the biggest mistake I made was not developing a database, not creating great first impressions, and then not having a system in place to build my brand with those people from that day forward where they never forget about me. So that was my biggest mistakes in my real estate business, because otherwise, if I would have been more focused on people, right? Because every relationship you put in place, regardless if they want to buy or sell today or not, this is something to maybe write down and remember here. Every relationship that you put in place, even if they are not interested in buying or selling today or not. And that's a big thing there, because a lot of people are only going after motivated buyers or sellers, and I'm not. I'm going after everybody. I want everybody to know who I am, what I do, and I'm here to help. But every relationship you put in place with someone in your market, regardless if they want to buy or sell today or not, is worth 10 to 20 deals to you over the life of your career.